Your marketing isn't working. You know how I know that? Because your phone isn't ringing off the hook, people aren't banging down your door to work with you, they don't understand how you can help them. This challenge, this problem, puts more businesses out of business than any other. So are you just gonna sit there and wait to go bankrupt? When you started your business, you focused on what you do and why you want to do it. You know that you have a skill set, you have a talent, you have value that you can drive to the people in your life. And here's the challenge, because when you focus on you, you say, I want to be a consultant, I want to be a coach, I want to be a home decorator, I want to be a fashion designer, and then you think, I'm going to create a brand, I'm going to create a marketing strategy for the world, and I will bring people in. But you start by focusing on you, not your targets, and that is the main problem. So we help a lot of clients through brand strategy, which is basically just this process of figuring out who you are and what you stand for, who the clients are, and just defining everything, just working through the entire process of this is the target audience. Where are they and what do they care about? Here is you. Here is what you do. Do those things even align? And in most cases, they do not. You want to sell your coaching. So here you are. You are a coach. You want to help a certain type of client, and here they are. Did you even stop to think about whether the type of coaching that you offer, the types of services you do, your approach, your pricing, how you work, does that even align with what it is people want? Most businesses start this way. They start over here and then they think, I'm going to put out a brand. Guess what? The marketing isn't working. The advertising isn't working because you're busy focusing on you. What if we flipped it? What if we thought about just the targets? What if we thought about what it is that they wanted? We have a saying, we have a philosophy here in Phanta, and that's to drive immediate and never-ending value. Think about it. If you are working with someone and you can drive immediate value, it means that you, right away from day one, you are driving value in their life, in their business. Never-ending value. This is value that you will drive week after week, month after month. You're going to work for their business. So this idea of not only driving long-term value, but immediate value today is a philosophy we have here. And the only way to be able to do that is to know what the targets actually want. So what if we blue-skied this? What if we didn't focus on who we are and what it is that we want to do? And then later try to market to these random people. What if we started with these people? How would we drive immediate and never-ending value for the customer? So it's first thinking about what type of customer do we want? What do they care about? What is it that they're looking for from someone? Who are these people and what is it that they need and what is it that they want? And then now reverse engineer the type of company you need to be to help these people. Right? You start with you. You say, I want to be this type of company, and then I'm going to go out and find people who need my service. Guess what? That's really, really hard. Right? Yeah, some people will align. Some people will line up, but you have to find the perfect person at the perfect time who exactly needs you. Why not look at two or three different types of people and say, who do I need to be to help these people overcome their challenge? What do I need to say to have trust or have credibility? What shortfalls in education do they have that I need to fill? How do I need to educate them, drag them forward, give them trust, bring them into a place where they are willing to work with me? If more companies spent more time focusing on who they needed to be to attract the type of customers they wanted, their sales, their marketing, everything would go up. Everything would hit the mark more because you are building your company for the person. You are not building it for yourself and then hoping that someone in the world will love you. You are building it for them. And so this comes down to everything from how you operate, to what you say, to how you market, to your photography, your colors, your logo. Think of everything all-encompassing, every single touch point from a customer. If you build your company based around the type of people that you want to attract and you say what it is that they need to hear to move forward and you give them the trust and the credibility and everything that they need to overcome their challenge, then you don't even have to sell. You're not even selling anything. You are literally just problem solving. Deal is done. But as long as you spend time only looking at who you are and never really understanding your customers, never really understanding what they want and don't want and how to move forward, you are never going to fix your marketing, your advertising is never going to work, and your sales will continue to plummet. So when I started my company, I started in January 2007, and by May, I was almost bankrupt. And the biggest problem I had was I didn't know how to explain what it is we did. So people would ask me, they say, what do you do? And I say, oh, well, I'm a corporate video producer. I help people market and communicate through video. At a certain point, I had to try and figure out how to explain what it is we did, because we were corporate video producers, and they say, well, you know, like, who could you work with? And I'd say, well, we work with all kinds of companies. And what do you help people do? We help them make videos. Okay, and why would they pick you? Well, they pick me if they need a video. I'm really good at making videos. Do you need a video? Like, it's just not a compelling message. It doesn't make any sense. And so what I did was I worked with a business coach to help me first start to understand who it is I'm speaking to. And so if I was speaking to someone in HR, they have a very different need than someone who's in internal communications, which is different from someone who is in marketing, which is different from someone who's in sales. The marketing person wants to be able to build a brand. They want to be able to generate leads. The entrepreneur wants to be able to look a certain way, build a certain profile, scale their business, maybe sales, maybe recruitment, who knows, a whole collection of different things, but they have different motivations. So I could be the same company, but I need to be able to shift what I'm saying for each of these people because what it is that they're buying is different. Everything takes the form of marketing or a video or what have you, but the reason they're buying it is vastly different. And so I want you to think about who it is that you're trying to attract and who it is you're trying to sell to. I want you to think about the things that they are buying, the things that they really desire and want. And then I want you to kind of forget who you are. I want you to forget the brand. I want you to forget your offer and your process. Just blue sky it. Who do I need to be in order to sell to these people? What needs to happen to make it happen? I ask myself that question all the time, right? I'm scared by my goals. I'm scared by shifting my company. I'm scared by taking on something too big. Okay, I'm not gonna take on something too big. I'm not gonna shift my company. I'm not gonna do any of those things. Just what needs to happen to make it happen? Who do I need to be able to make this deal? And then I can decide whether I wanna do it or not. But if your sales are really hurting, if your marketing isn't working, if you are like me, 5 months in on the verge of going bankrupt because I couldn't figure this out, take a step back, figure out, of course, who you are, but more importantly, focus on the customer you want. And of course, you have to think big, you have to be bold, and you have to say yes. If growing and scaling your business by being better at sales and better at marketing, better at customer experience is important to you, be sure to check out this video right over here. And like always, subscribe to my channel, click on the bell icon, and get each video every day when it drops.